Double!
And this is Friday Frenzy!
The sights, the sounds, the school spirit, the football. Get ready for Friday Frenzy with the WATE 6 and your side sports team.
LeBron James has Taco Tuesday. We got Friday Frenzy, week 3, coming in hot. I'm Marshall Hughes, Mark Whiteman there, Jordan Kramer. Going to join us in just a bit.
Yeah, we might try and trademark it, too. A ton of area teams playing out of area programs this week. We will get to those, but we've got to start right down the road with still perfect Powell facing Fulton. A lot of excitement around this Panthers team this year. Marshall looking for their first 3-0 start since 2012. Falcons trying to get out of this early season hole. In a hole down 14 zip. Tommy Sweat retreating, drifting, keeping his eyes downfield, finding as he finally releases Tyler Kirkus. Not the one he was looking for. Powell's defense showing up and showing out. Baylor Hughes, he's doing it for the Panthers. He's going to be bringing the thunder right here as he bulldozes his way on into the end zone. Panthers up 3 scores. And Matt Lowe, man, he's got to be loving what he's seeing from his Panthers team over the first few weeks of the season. And what's not to love? Jordan Brown to the timeshare. Powell blanks the Falcons. 34 zip. It's a good time to be a Panthers fan.
These kids have been working for this same goal since January, and so they've certainly turned it up a notch in June and July, and now that they've started playing games, they've found ways to win. And, you know, we talk about it constantly. We're not worried about any individual stats. The one thing we're looking for are team wins, and so here they are now 3 games in, and so far they found one every week.
They'll try and find another on the road at Cards next Friday. Marshall.
State champ Central off to a 2-0 start. The Bobcats rallied past Fulton last week. We're hosting Sevier County tonight. The Smoky Bears jumped out to a 10-0 lead, though. Dakota Farver, not easy to wrap up. The senior avoiding the sack gets the rock in Makai Anderson's hands. That moves the chains, makes way for another Jason Merritt's touchdown. Dude was feeling it tonight. Hits third on the night. We're just in the third quarter. Central leads 33-13. Farver might have given a play of the year nominee tonight. Uh-oh. Here. The quarterback scrambling. And when I say scrambling, the dude was scrambling. He eventually finds the opening, heaves it to Isaiah Osborne, and we got ourselves 6. Central rolls 55-13. How about West? The Rebels have taken down Bearden and Farragut in back-to-back weeks. Carnes on tap tonight. Beavers run through the banner onto the field. West starts fast, too. Quarterback Baker Dance with the play-action fake. He finds Amari on right, and he's going to outrun the Carnes defense for the touchdown. West up 7-0. Rebels defense pitching the shutout tonight, too. Linebacker Daquan Crenshaw stopping that Carnes running back, Deshaun Bishop, in the backfield. West offense, though, with another explosive play. Baker Dance airs it out to a wide-open Grant Tierney for the touchdown. I heard that they had 6 scoring drives tonight, Mark, and only one of them took longer than a minute 25. West doing their thing, 45-0.
That's why you want a quarterback named Baker. Week 3, Austin East still looking for their first points of the year. They get him in bunches against Kingston. Trey Foster deep in thought. Chris Green deep in execution. Roadrunners in the red zone. Wild runner or Wild Road, whatever you want. The fans are loving it. They're so glad they go to AE. Here we go. Direct snap to Isaiah Ligon. All kinds of shifty. Look at this. He will not be denied on his way into the end zone. No Acme to trip him up tonight. Roadrunners Steady Eddie with a 34-22 win. Oak Ridge and Campbell County hooking up in Jacksboro. Cougar Nation, Jack Strong. Wildcats 0-2 for the first time this century. They'd only scored 12 points this quarter. More than doubled that in the first half. Mitchell Gibbons to Isaiah Johnson. That was the first of many scores for Mr. Johnson. Tonight up 21 zip and just warming up. Gibbons to Jonathan Stewart. Do a barrel roll. Oak Ridge all over Campbell County late in the first half. Like a dealer with an ace, they're taking insurance. Gibbons to Tyrell Romano for the 42-yard score down the sideline. Oak Ridge shuts out the Cougars 40-0. Jordan Kramer there on a big night for the Wildcats.
Hey, guys, when you start the season 0-2 for the first time in at least 19 years, it's pretty easy to let anger seep in to the practice field and the playing field, but that's exactly what the seniors at Oak Ridge didn't want to happen. So that senior class had a meeting this week, and they talked about how they needed to hold each other accountable, but they needed to do so in a positive manner. No yelling, no screaming, just uplift one another. And they told me afterwards they think that that was the difference in tonight's game.
It helped the team decide to just be positive, and that changes the game a lot.
Playing mad, you're not playing right. If you're playing happy and you're having fun, that changes the whole game.
At practice, you know, we started, like, you know, shaking hands and stuff and just, like, being together as a group instead of just individuals. And I think that carries over with the game.
We have started off with a rough game, rough two games. So, like, we were just trying to figure out what we could do for something to happen like this today.
Coach Gattis reminded his team all week in practice and then again after this game that this game was the mark of a new season for them as they entered region play, and they are now 1-0 in that new season. We'll send it back to you.
Looking good in that start of the season as well. So Wildcats, they're starting to look more like themselves. Big one next week against Farragut.
Yeah, great night for Oak Ridge tonight. South Doyle hoping for the same result, home to Gibbs. And unfortunately, some bad news to start off. Quarterback Mason Brang helped off the field with a pretty serious leg injury, it seemed like. Just a couple plays later, Elijah Young picking his team up. The short touchdown run to put the Cherokees up 31-10 at the half. We'll have more on Brang when we get the news. Meanwhile, early in the third, Elijah Young now wearing jersey number 41. Did he have a wardrobe malfunction during the game? We don't know that either, but shedding some tacklers, runs it all the way to the end zone. South Doyle goes on to get the win over Gibbs tonight. Final score, 62-17.
Looking like Alvin Kamara in that jersey, too.
Yep, that's true. At least two decades have come and gone. Now 3-0. No 3-0 starts for the Hall's Red Devils. Our team of the week hosting Clinton with a chance to end the drought. First play of the game. Hall says, how about a little razzle-dazzle? Colin Heck takes the toss, decides to go deep. Tay Rucker, wide open, coasts in for six. Scott Cummings, all about it. Just loves the start of that game. Red Devils making more moves later in the first. Ty Humphrey rolls out right, throws back to his left. That misdirection toss to Jake Paris gives Halls all the mojo. This had the feel of the blowout early on, but props to Clinton for not backing down. Eli DeShome gets the Dragons on the board. He's on Matt Hagan's fantasy team, so that's a win-win. Halls gets the last laugh, though. 34-26, the Red Devils are 3-0. Friday Frenzy is just heating up tonight. After the break, Wes Jones making his way back to Hardin Valley, this time as an assistant at Science Hill.
And Bearden looking for its first win, but it had to come against a tough Dobbins-Bennett squad. But first, you know what time it is. Let's boogie.
Get on your feet.